Yo, what's up, my people? Welcome to the final episode of The Expanse, the Telltale game. We're at Europol's Folly for this final episode. Drummer takes on the pirates and Arion in the final gambit to recover the MK core and save her crew. So before we finish this, two things. Number one, there's going to be no commentary throughout this entire thing till the end, when I critique the story, how I felt about this chapter and the entire game in general. That's going to be at the end of the episode. So after this, no commentary. The other thing is that you should know that endings will differ for each person and how they played. So there is no right or wrong way to play it, but if you want certain endings, you may have to replicate what I do or others do to get those endings. So with that being said, I hope you guys enjoy the final episode, episode 5 of The Expanse, the Telltale game. Let's do this. Yeet.
Be down there.
Drummer?
This one is scared. He's shaking like a baby quail. You do it.
I don't have a gun.
Don't need one. Use your mag boots. Crush his skull and be done with it.
No, please. Drummer, don't. I saved you from Arlen. I never wanted Maya to die. I need help.
Ugh.
Virgil! Virgil, open the door!
Captain, you're alive?
He could be a lot worse. The auto doc says his condition is stable, but he needs attention.
We should check his vitals then.
What's wrong?
They're gonna take me away. The pirates, they'll turn me over to the UNN or the OPA. Once they take the ship, they'll...
If they take the ship, we can fight them off, but we need... The OPA? Why would they want you?
The OPA has a standing kill order for any soldier that was present on...
Anderson Station.
I understand your anger.
Do you? You were at Anderson fucking Station! You were a soldier in the greatest massacre in the history of the Belt, and you hid it from me! Gah! Give me one reason I shouldn't leave you here to fend for yourself!
I should. You need to help the rest of your crew, and I'm no use to you like this. Leave me.
I don't have time for this. But I don't think I can make it through this without you either. That matters is getting through this attack, and I need my medic for that. If you had a patient who was panicking, what would you do to help them?
I'd recommend some deep breaths, maybe brew some tea, but deep breaths to start, I suppose.
What else?
I'd speak softly, use a non-judgmental tone, and try to project an attitude of safety and security.
Virgil, the situation is bad. But we've already been through worse. And survived. And we're going to get through this. I'm going to help you. And then you're going to help me.
Yes, Captain.
Okay. What would you do next?
Well, first, I'd assess the patient's fears, try to get to the heart of what's keeping them in an agitated state.
You don't want to lose your head, like the soldiers on the Ushinabi.
Once the pirates find out the truth about me, death will be the least of my problems.
What next?
Reframing the situation. Often it helps to introduce favorable outcomes, to concretize obtainable constructive
force. So think positively.
In short, yes.
Once we are through with this, you can go back to being a medic. Your past will stay between us. You can keep living in the Belt.
You'd let me remain a medic after...
You're not just our medic. You're the one who makes kibble for the rest of us. You take care of the crew, Virgil. Help me save them, and you can keep doing it.
Thank you, Captain. I appreciate your help more than I can say. I'll retrieve my hand terminal. Before you go, Anderson Station.
We don't have time.
I know, but please, you must understand. I never raised my gun. I was there to treat the injured soldiers. I wanted to. There was nothing I could do for the civilians.
I know.
You don't. I'm sure you cannot understand the base cowardice of someone who merely follows orders. Regardless of what happens to us, I must know. Can you ever forgive me?
I know what it's like to be manipulated into doing something terrible by someone you trust. But forgiveness isn't mine to give.
What can I do?
You already left the UNN. You came to the Belt, where you knew you'd still be in danger. You wanted to find a home. And you found one. Now you must fight for it. You still have work to do here.
Thank you, Captain. I'll check on the patient and be ready for whatever happens next.
Khan? Are you okay?
Looks like she handled it.
Took you long enough.
I blew my cover. They're sending another boarding party.
Almost here.
Ah!
You're hurt.
I'm ecstatic. You sent more pirates to kill, Drummer. You shouldn't have.
They'll send more this time. We need a plan.
There's no time. Aim and shoot. You need a better plan than that? Now pipe down and let me enjoy this. Yeehaw, cockfuckers!
Let me see.
There's no point. I just wanted to take the rest of them with me before.
Come on. We need to get you to Virgil.
Good flying with you. Thank you.
I'm going to kill a lot more pirates for you before this is over. I promise. Coming for you.
Captain, I heard gunfire. Are you injured?
I'm fine, but Khan, she's dead.
I'm sure you did everything you could. There will be a time to grieve later. For now, I'll take care of the body.
Thank you, Virgil. Arlen is in the cargo bay with the MK Corps. Firing at the Artemis was risky, but I knew the crew could handle it. They didn't let me down. Even if I do survive the pirates and Arlen, I'll need to find a way off this ship before it falls apart. Kept me alive so far.
Came to shoot me in the back, eh, Drummer?
is better than a Pashangwala like you deserves.
Still thinking you're better than me? That's your problem. That's why you lose. You turn your back on me and Bharatna, just like you turn your back on Dawes and the OPA.
You think you're Beltalotta, Arlen? No, you're just another murderous thug.
Shut up.
That's why the OPA rejected you. They saw you for the crazy Owala you are.
Enough.
She was more of a belter than you'll ever be. She didn't have to die. Why? Why? Why?
Trouble with your crew, Captain.
I have the MK core. Put a bullet in this bitch's head and we can split the profit.
I wonder, Kamina Drummer, do you believe in grace? I do. It's what sustained me in that wretched cave the Indians locked me in. It's what binds me and my crew together as family. And this war at this moment gives me pause from killing you. When a weaker, pettier person would savor the opportunity. But grace must be earned. Convince me your life matters, and I will let you live.
My crew member, Maya. She sacrificed her life for mine. Every day I live is about honoring that sacrifice.
Because you loved her?
Because I owe her.
Don't you see how we're meant to be together? Kindred spirits. Two bodies in the same orbit. Finally we meet and you want to squander it all? How much time have you wasted serving inadequate men? Or trying to fight every battle by yourself? Circumstances set us against each other, but we are not victim to circumstance. Even now, after all the blood between us, we can seize this chance to build a new future together. You could have your own ship in my fleet. Name it after Maya. Use it to fight the MCRN and help defect us to the belt. Our buyer will make us wealthy enough that we can build our own system if we want, and make sure we are always protected.
Who is your buyer?
It's a private company.
There are no private companies in the belt. Is it Checkman? Royal Charter?
It doesn't matter. One rich J-Meng or another, they're all the same. What matters is what we do with it.
You think you can trust the Inners? That they will hand you money and leave you alone? You're insane.
And you're a fool with no vision. Pity.
Captain Drummer. Drummer, this is Julie Mao. You've held up your end of the bargain, and now I've held up mine. All the pirates on board the Europa Spain are dead.
No!
Yeah, look, this is an open broadcast, so I don't know if you're hearing me or who else is. But your crew is on board, and I have the Artemis on target lock. If I don't receive a response from you soon, I will assume the ship has gone hostile and blow it to shit. Good luck.
I'd offer you everything.
You have nothing to offer me. I fight for the belt. Ready torpedoes!
Captain Drummer. Captain, are you there?
I'm here. I'm on the hull.
She's alive! Stay right there. I'll be out to assist you. You're safe now, Captain. We're all safe.
Nearing Ceres Station, Captain. Are you sure we're cleared for approach?
We're clear. Dawes controls the docks, and he's decided to lift the bounty on me and play nice. For now, at least.
Captain Drummer. Drummer. We're almost there. Which means it's almost too late.
I know.
Did you at least listen to the message?
No need. I know my answer.
Look, I'm heading to Ceres because that's where my contacts are. And it's where a girl with some basic wrenching skills can do a little good. What's there for you anymore?
Same as you. It's where I'm needed.
I know fuck all about the belt. But I do know the difference between a foot soldier and a leader. Just hear him out. You never know, right?
Drummer, this is Fred Johnson. I believe the last time we met, you were holding a gun to my head. But what's past is past. I think you'd agree. I understand you are returning to Ceres. I am calling to offer you an alternative. I do not claim to speak for the Belt. Any person who would do so is as foolish as they are dangerous. The Belt is a fractious, toilsome tinderbox, a graveyard of ideals and ambition. It is also, I believe, the last great hope for humankind. The Inners have forgotten how to build. Their focus is on killing each other and controlling Belters. I know this firsthand. But Belters are builders. We forge new worlds out of rock and metal. It doesn't matter where we came from or the demons in our past. It only matters what we can contribute right now. I know that you have suffered and lost, and that through it all, you never forgot what you were fighting for. That is why I need you here on Tycho as my partner for a new OPA. Come speak with me. See what I am building. You have much to contribute, Drummer. Don't let it be wasted.
Damn it. Change coordinates. We're making a stop at Tycho Station.
Of course, Captain. May I ask, what is on Tycho?
Let's find out.
So guys, we did it. We finished The Expanse. We completed all episodes of The Expanse. You can see it shows right there. I was kind of late. This was this came out like a week or so ago, but it'd been so many games come out, as you guys know. And we were late to the party. I'm gonna skip the credits and get right to the choices. Now, I did like the ending. I like the fact they didn't draw out the ending as well, that it went right, they just popped right into it and got right to the action. It made it one of them more exciting episodes, of course, not just because of the ending, but because it just got right into business. It didn't prolong it. They didn't give you a bunch of things to do. They didn't like send you through a bunch of like lasers and stuff to get to the point that you need to get to. And I liked that. And I said the laser things for, you know, the laser trials that they gave you sometime. So anyway, our choices compared to the communities, these are me and my daughter's choices. So 85%, which is what we chose to save Ryan from Tor. 50% chose to do otherwise. We also chose the 83%, the popular choice. Drummer stayed with Virgil when he was panicking. And you can see the other choices. Only 4% left Virgil when he was panicking. So that's interesting. Common Virgil, 59%. Oh man, maybe there's some help for people out there after all. 59% actually helped Virgil. 26% failed to con Virgil. And 15% didn't even try to con Virgil. So once again, we did the popular choices, like 58% Drummer told Virgil he needed to make amends in the belt. 1% told Virgil she couldn't forgive him. So that's interesting. Wow, there's some passionate people out there playing The Expanse. Shout out to you. In Tor's death, we also chose the popular thing. 81% arrived after Khan killed Tor. 19% killed Tor. Why were they doing what? Okay. 86% helped kill the boarding party with Khan. 14% chose to do the other and never sent a boarding party. Oh, for the first time, we chose something that didn't happen. So you can actually have Khan survive. Maybe because I was screwing up some of my... I don't think I screwed any of my gunshots up in that. But Khan was killed in the gunfight. We did the latter. It's kind of half split. 53% had Khan survive the encounter with the pirates. So Khan could have survived. 80%, which what we did, killed Arlen. Who wouldn't kill Arlen? I want to know who you are. No shout out to you. Right? Hold up. Let me go back. But actually, everybody killed. But one could have been Toussaint killing Arlen. The other one could have been Rayan killing Arlen. So it could have been different people killing Arlen. But he was going to die regardless. We also chose the popular one on why Drummer matters. Drummer chose Maya as the reason for her life matter. I mean, you got to give that shout out. I think like most people, if you cared about the relationship with her and Maya, you wanted to tell a good story as well for yourself or others watching, you would choose Maya, you know, in some form of fashion. You got to give her a shout out, right? So there you go. But 26% chose the belt as the reason for her matter. And last and least, people chose justice as the reason her life mattered. I chose Maya as well because I felt like she thought family and love and all that shit. Oh, excuse me, all that stuff matter. I don't know what's wrong with my mouth today. Why I got a potty mouth. But that's why I would have chose that. And 73%, just like we decided, had to face the pirates unarmed. 27% found a shotgun for a final fight with the pirates. Doing it unarmed is kind of cool, though. It's kind of like dramatic and whatnot. But yeah, I thought The Expanse was pretty good. You know, it wasn't, the price of a mission isn't as much games, and it gives you a good set of hours to play. So overall, I think it was worth it. And then for those that want to, you know, go back through it, try different paths, see what else they can find, there's replayability there. So I think money-wise, it's definitely a good game. I really enjoyed it. I think my daughter enjoyed it. You enjoyed it, right? It was a good time for us, you know, family-wise to play. So it could also be a family game. I consider all Telltale games or choice made game good family games, especially when your family's like, let's say you want to watch a movie, but you don't really want to do a movie. You want to do something different. You want to do something interactive. And that's why I think these games are going to be like the future of entertainment. You know, choice made movies, like you decide what happens. You and your family goes to it. You're the director, kind of. You make the big time decisions and see what happens, you know. I don't know if anybody know about this. Back in the day, there were these books where you could choose like what to do, and then you flip to a certain page to continue the story with your choice. These games remind me of those books. But with that being said, once again, shout out to Telltale Games, their PR department, and everyone who hooked me up with a copy of the game to play. Now to other games that we need to finish. And while this game is very exclusive to ADG Entertainment, don't forget, if you want to see me play through more games, check out ADG Versus Game. And with that being said, we're going to end it right here. I'll see you guys next show, next video. I'm out of here.